Friends, hear the promises of God. We would not have you ignorant, brothers and sisters, concerning those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Jesus said, "So you have sorrow now, but I will see you again, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy from you. Behold, I am coming soon. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end." Friends, we gather to commend to God and the ground with thanksgiving the ashes of Mary Sundstrom as we celebrate the good news of Christ's resurrection. For whether we live or whether we die, we belong to Christ, who is Lord both of the living and the dead. Scripture and music were very important pieces of Mary's life and faith. So this morning, we will have the opportunity to hear both. We'll hear scripture selections that were favorites of Mary's and that speak to many of you. And we'll hear music that Mary loved, as well as music that reminds you all of Mary. So let us begin with the promises of God's loving pursuit of us all through the familiar and comforting words of Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of thy enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely, surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. At this time, Mary's daughter Barb would like to say a few words.
In the last several years, Mom would tell me something she wanted me to make sure happened when she died. It was never easy for me to talk about with her, even though she was so matter-of-fact about it. And I would add it to the list I made. One day, she said in a cheery voice, "Barb, I thought of something I want at my funeral." "What is that?" I replied. "I want 'You Are My Sunshine' to be played." She said it was always one of her favorite songs. When you look past the chorus of the song, it seems pretty sad. I like to concentrate on the chorus. I decided to write down the lyrics and look through the questions the Google provides next to information about the song. I really liked what it had to say, and so I'd like to share it with you. What does the metaphor, "You are my sunshine," mean? It means you are the light of my life. You are dear to me. You are important and special. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. I'm happy that you are near me.
The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken, and I hung my head and cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Thank you. you really love me, and no one else could come between. But now you've left me, and you love another. You have shattered all my dreams. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Mary liked to write in the margins of her Bible. And in her Bible, next to the following psalm, Mary had written a note that read simply, God's love and faithfulness. These are words that spoke to Mary and reminded her of the depth of God's love and the breadth of God's faithfulness to her. May you hear echoes of what Mary heard in this scripture from the 85th psalm. Let me hear what God the Lord will speak, for he will speak peace to his people, to his faithful, to those who turn to him in their hearts. Surely his salvation is at hand for those who fear him, that his glory may dwell in our land. Steadfast love and faithfulness will meet. Righteousness and peace will kiss each other. Faithfulness will spring up from the ground, and righteousness will look down from the sky. The Lord will give what is good, and our land will yield its increase. Righteousness will go before him and will make a path for his steps. Will you pray with me, please? O God, our strength and our Redeemer, giver of life and conqueror of death, we praise you with humble hearts. We praise you for your steadfast love for Mary all the days of her earthly life, and we thank you for all that she was to those who loved her. We thank you that for Mary, death itself is past, and that she has entered the home where all your people gather in peace. Keep us all in communion with your faithful people, in every time and in every place, that at last we may rejoice together with the heavenly family, where Christ reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. As people of faith, we, like the Apostle Paul, are persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Because of this, we can, in hope and in faith, commit our earthly vessels into God's care. And so we say, Creator God, who breathed into lifeless dust to bring forth humans in your image and in whose eternal care are all your people, we return to the earth the ashes of your servant, Mary Sundstrom, believing that as you raise Jesus Christ from death, you will breathe life into us again so that we may live with you forever. Amen. As memories of Mary were shared in the wake of her passing, one thing about her just kept coming up over and over and over again. Her smile. So it's only fitting that the final piece of music that we hear today at her final resting place is the song Smile. As you listen, I invite you to think of your favorite memories with Mary in the hopes that her smile then would bring a smile to your lips and your hearts now. And as you smile, and as you remember, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Amen.
aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by.
If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you.
Light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near,
that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying?
You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you
with gladness.
My life.